Dear customer, congratulations with your new Knaus caravan. In this video, I will explain you everything on the in and outside of the caravan, how it works. So, follow me, we start on the outside. As you can see, this vehicle has a place for two bicycles. And if you want to use the bicycles, this one you can bring it to the front of the caravan so that you have the space for the gas bottles. Additional, you can buy if you want a spare wheel. There's the place for the spare wheel. We have two bike holders inside the caravan so that you can store your two vehicles and the bicycles. And if you want to close the front for the gas bottles, two handles to release, and then you can put the complete aluminium bicycle holder to the front of the caravan so that you can close the front for the gas bottles. At the other side of the caravan, we have a locker for fresh water, for warm water, and to drain the fresh water. All the locks, they work with the same key. Here we have the place for the electricity. Normally we have this little holder that you can put the cable down from the caravan and put it in the caravan so that you can close without the cable between the
door.
Here you can fill your fresh water. Very easy. Release the cap and use a hose or anything else what you use to fill the water. If you want to drain the water, you have the little blue button on the down of the water tank, and at the left we have two little drains for the warm water, so you have to release them if you don't use the water anymore. Let's go to the back of the caravan. This one is also equipped with an extra bike holder for two bicycles at the back of the caravan. If you want to use it, just undo these little straps. And totally, we've got four. Put it down, and inside the caravan, we have a little aluminium holder so that you can bring down the complete bike holder just a little lower, and then you can easily put two bicycles on your bike holder, and with the aluminium holder you put it upwards and then it's on the same position as it now is. So it makes it very easy to put on the two bicycles on the bike holder. Here's the toilet. If you want to release the toilet, little holder, put it upwards, and then you can put the complete tank out. You have the two wheels, so you can move it on the camping. And if you want to drain it, you have to turn this one, put the cap off, and when you empty it, put the button, and then you can fill it with the fluids which you need for the toilet. Come inside. Welcome to the interior of the caravan. And in this video, I will explain how the gas works, how the refrigerator works, the radio and everything else what's inside. We have the possibility for two gas bottles in the front of the caravan, and if you want to use the stove or the fridge or the heater, you have to use the gas switches. There are three of them and they are inside this closet. The first one here is for the heater, the second one for the fridge, and the third one is for the stove. In the vertical position, they're open, and if you put them horizontal, the picture explains how it works, you close it. So if you don't use any of them, easily just put it horizontal and they're shut. The spark is on electricity, so if you open the gas bottle in the front, you have three buttons, and with the little picture you can see which one is for which gas, and just turn it, and as you can hear, it sparks automatically. For the fridge, it's also possible to put it on gas if you want. If you want to use the fridge, there's a little push button on the left. Fridge goes on, and as you can see, now it runs on electricity. If you want to switch on any of them, just push the button in the middle, and then the flashlight blinks, and you can switch to any of the possibilities you want. This is on the gas. The second one is on the 12 volt of the car, and the first one is on electricity. And after you choose on this way, then gas, push another time. This is for the temperature, and it sparks automatically. You don't have to use a little push button to ignite. If you want to use the fridge on gas, if you don't have electricity, there's a little holder inside the fridge where you can put a couple of batteries, because the fridge don't ignite if it doesn't have 12 volt. So if you don't have normal electricity and you want to use the fridge because the electricity has gone, just put some batteries inside here, and then you can use the fridge also on gas. Later I will explain the heater, because then we go back on the caravan. For the water, as I have shown, you can fill it on the outside of the caravan. Now the water system is completely empty. There are two extra ventils inside the caravan to drain the water. They're on the couch. So if you want to use the water, please check if they are closed. Otherwise you don't have any water at all. When you use the water, for cold water, it doesn't take much long. When you put it to the right, you have the cold water. In a couple of seconds, directly from the water tank to the taps. If you want to use warm water, it takes a lot of more time at the beginning, because you have to fill the water boiler with 5 liters. So the first time when you fill the warm water tank, it takes approximately 30 seconds, 1 minute. Some air comes out, and after you got a nice water, then you know the water tank for the warm water is completely filled. And after that, you can switch on for warm water, which I now will show where it is.
Okay. Like on the bed.
Sit here. Here's the switch for the warm water. It usually comes with a little light green. It's on or off. It's no problem if you leave it on, because when you have fresh water in the boiler, you can leave the boiler on. Please do check if you always have water, otherwise you are cooking nothing and the boiler can be broken. Okay. Now we go to the back of the caravan. And I will demonstrate how the heater works. Also on gas, as we have shown the gas switches. Also this one runs the spark on electricity with a little battery that's on in at the back of the the heater. Just turn this little knob here, and it's I will recommend that you first use the stove so gas can flow into the hoses, and after you use the stove later, then you can use the heater. Just turn it as you hear the ignition starts, push the button, and after a few seconds the ignition stops, and through this little hole here you can see the flame. It's also possible that you want to have the warmth of the heater do the caravan. There's a little ventilator with the button down here. You can turn to manual or automatic, or if you just want to circulate the air without using the heater, you can use this little fan logo, and with the upper button you can turn how much and how fast you want to have the air flowing through the caravan. And on the automatic position, then it will blow some air after the heater warms up. But I recommend just do manual and then turn the little button on the top. Toilet with shower. Actually very easy. Same tap for warm and cold water. The toilet, also the water for flushing, comes from the fresh water tank, so you don't have to fill the water for the toilet on the outside. Everything comes from the same water tank. Button here in the middle is to flush. It shows you if the waste tank is half full or complete full, or that you doesn't have correctly put the tank back. This little light blinks up, so then you have to push it a little more inside, otherwise you can't flush the toilet. And if you want to use it, at the front here is a little switch. Just pull the switch and then you can use the toilet. After you're done, push the button, toilet flows. And last but not least, please do close it. this caravan also comes with the feature from the radio. The caravan has not a normal radio, but a Bluetooth module. It's on the closet here up above. It's just inside here. You can see how it's what kind of module it is. It works with Bluetooth, so if you have your smartphone, you can connect your smartphone with the module. The password is also written here on the label, and then you can put some music and stream it to the Bluetooth module, and you have your best songs playing on the radio. Also TV, if you want, you can put the TV on. Here have you electricity. If you have a TV on 12 volt, we have a cable, and there are two cables for the connection with the camping. This one with the blue, it's connected with the one on the outside, so you can easily plug the cable on the outside from the camping, plug this one on your television, and you can watch TV. I think we go outside. Now I will demonstrate you how the awning works. In this way, it's an aluminium awning from Thule, called Thule Omnistore. And you got the aluminium stick with a little button to make it longer or shorter. connect the aluminium stick with the awning, and please make sure that you connect it, that it's secured. Otherwise, when you turn, it comes out and put some damage on the caravan. So it's very easy, just put it in, turn it clockwise and pull to make sure it's secured. After that, you can turn and the awning comes a little bit out and falls a little bit down. Just 1 meter at the first is enough. You can't put it completely outside without using these support legs, which are hidden at the aluminium from the front of the awning. Here you can see the aluminium support, the aluminium holder, and it works with a feather. So just give it a push, it comes out, and then you can lower it. This little clip here is to secure it. Put it down, give it some support, put it upwards, and you can do the same from the other way. It makes sense to do it together. One is turning and the other one is having this support at the front of the awning. So if I turn it now, also inside there are two extra holders to have some extra security. If you want to tighten the fabric because it's stormy weather, you have these little bars at the front. Just give it a little push and you can secure it in one of these aluminium holders, so that you make sure that the fabric is nice, tight and smooth. I will recommend for the awning an hold down strap kit, so then you can secure the awning with the two aluminium holders above here, which are available at our shop, or you can buy it at Thule.com. So I would recommend that you buy them. After that, when you're done, just easy, turn it back, take the aluminium holders with you. This one too. Actually the same as turning it outside, but then reverse. Last video I will explain how the mover of the caravan works, so that you can move the caravan by electricity. And if you want to use the mover, we got the little locker here with battery and also a key to make some ignition. The battery is on the right side. It's a lithium ion battery from 20 ampere, and approximately you can use it for 30-45 minutes, and after that you have to recharge it. Recharging is very easy. Put the electricity on the caravan and it automatically recharges the battery. For the first, at the beginning, if you want to use the mover, put off this little cap and you got the key to make some electricity. Now you can see up above there's a green light blinking. Now you can make the connection with the little holder. On the side is a little switch. Green light comes on. If you don't had used the red key, this green light will blink, so that you know you have forgotten to use the red key. And after that, you've got two buttons to use the engines of the mover to bring them on the wheels of the caravan. So if I use these two buttons at the same time, we hold them, and after that the blue light comes on, and now you can see the two engines are moving to the wheel of the caravan. It stops automatically, and also the other side of the caravan, the mover is also on the tire. Little signal, and please do not forget to put off the handbrake. And now it's very easy. With the buttons, you can go to the front or the back. And you can put the caravan wherever you like. Okay. After you're done movering, put the handbrake on first, just to make sure it doesn't roll away. And after that, you got the two buttons down. Just put them both. And now the engines from the mover are getting away from the tire. And also a little signal blinks, and also a little sound comes when it's ready. So now it's done. Little switch, and also the red switch inside, and you're done movering. There's also a little spare part. It's an aluminium bar. Just when you're movering the caravan and the battery is empty, the engines from the mover are on the wheels, you won't able to go away with the caravan. So there's also a possibility to get the engines from the tires manually. At the back of the mover is a little cap. Put off the cap, and you can use this special instrument to get the engines from the tires. And you have to do that on both sides of the caravan. But it's just in case of an emergency, when the battery is empty or you have some problems with the mover. That's it.